Florence, Italy, back in the days when you were still allowed to travel. It's home to the incredible Ponte Vecchio, the impressive Palazzo Vecchio, and the incredibly impressive Florence Cathedral. Oh, and the single most famous statue in the world, David. And when most people see David for the first time, they have one tiny burning question. I think you know where I'm going with this. Why does he have such an extraordinarily small crack on his foot? You see, this damaged part here. Well, this story begins 500 years ago, when the statue was carved from a single block of marble by Italian artist Michelangelo, based upon the biblical figure from David and Goliath. He's holding a rock in one hand and has a slingshot draped over his shoulder. The statue was originally intended to be placed atop the Florence Cathedral, but upon completion it was far too heavy, weighing over 6 tons. Instead, they plonked him outside the Palazzo Vecchio, where he stood still as a statue for the next 369 years. But the authorities were concerned about the damaging effects of the elements, and so in 1873, David was moved inside the nearby Galleria dell'Accademia, being replaced by a replica outside the palace. And then during World War II, he was entombed in a brick silo in order to protect him from bombs. It worked. Whilst parts of the city were reduced to mere rubble, David survived intact. And even today, the gallery are taking no risks, with plans to install an anti-seismic platform to protect the statue both from earthquakes and the damaging effects of 8 million tourists' yearly footsteps. My point is, for centuries, Florence has taken extraordinary measures to keep its beloved statue safe. But then in 1991, a visitor entered the gallery armed with a hammer and started attacking it. He was promptly restrained and arrested, but the damage was done, and however small, it was irreversible. The most famous statue in the world, that had been kept safe for half a millennium, had been permanently damaged in just a few seconds of mindless vandalism. And the sad thing is, this is nothing new. Let's take another famous example. In fact, the most famous example, the Mona Lisa. Now, the queue to see it was over 2 hours long, so I didn't bother. Instead, here's some lovely footage of the Louvre's hallways. Anyway, in the early 1950s, a man who claimed to be in love with the painting cut it with a razor and attempted to steal it, which, as well as being a highly inadvisable way to declare your love, led to the painting being encased in glass. But then a few years later, someone else threw a rock at it, smashing the glass and damaging the paintwork. I'm not pointing any fingers, but this guy's got a history of throwing rocks at things. Since then, bulletproof glass has been used, and it's done a pretty successful job. In 1974, a woman sprayed it with red paint, and then more recently in 2009, another woman threw a teacup at the painting. But on both occasions, the glass case protected the masterpiece from damage. Perhaps the most relevant example today is the work of Banksy, arguably the world's most famous living artist. Wherever his pieces pop up, they're almost certainly followed by attempted vandalism, and hasty and often unsuccessful attempts to protect them. In late 2018, for instance, his piece Season's Greetings appeared on a garage wall in Port Talbot, Wales. Port Talbot is a town famed for its steel industry and subsequent pollution, and the artwork seemed to play on this. On one side of the garage was a child catching snowflakes on his tongue, but around the corner, the revelation that it's actually ash from a burning skip. A friend of mine, YouTuber Andrew Maderfilm, headed there for a closer look, only to find the piece covered by protective screening, and then further surrounded by a metal fence.
What do you think?
It's difficult to say, really.
This was the first time I'd been to see something in person, and somehow had a worse view of it.
There was a happy ending to this one. The protective measures worked, and the artwork was safely moved to a gallery in the town centre, where it's able to be enjoyed by everyone. But one of Banksy's most recent pieces wasn't so lucky. A couple of months ago, Valentine's Day appeared on the side of a house in Bristol, and within just 48 hours it was defaced. The really sad part here is that the artwork belongs to the house's owner, who've just had the joy and elation of essentially winning the lottery, only to have the six-figure ticket torn up in front of their eyes, all because of a few senseless seconds of vandalism. I guess you're expecting some kind of pseudo-scientific conclusion about human psychology and man's unrelenting need to destroy something beautiful, but I don't have one. I just think it's a shame when people try to ruin things. There will always be people who, for whatever reason, want to spoil the enjoyment of others, and we've just got to do our best to deter them and enjoy ourselves in spite of them. Whether it's with the airport-like security now required to see the statue of David, the bulletproof glass and 2-hour queue required for a glance at the Mona Lisa, or the literal digging up of an entire garage and transporting it to an art gallery. Great art is something that is undeniably worth protecting, no matter the cost. I thoroughly encourage you to check out Andrew's channel. He makes some of the most creative and original videos on YouTube, and he's criminally underrated, so please head over there and take a look.